Once there was a land where everyone had a mirror. In the land of mirrors, people enjoyed looking at themselves.
I enjoy looking at myself. I look really good.
Actually, she didn't look that good. She just imagined that she did.
Mirror, mirror in my hand. Who's the fairest in the land? Oh, yes, I agree. You're looking at her.
Their mirrors, you see, they were covered with soot and dirt and grime. So covered were their mirrors that no image was reflected in the glass at all. Yet still they looked and stared and said things like,
how there's one fine human being.
Actually, her teeth were full of cavities, and she was missing several right up front. But the mirror would never tell.
Huh. What a face. What a body. What a gift.
What a joke. Not seeing any image in their mirrors, they used their imaginations instead. They saw what they wanted to see, and they fooled themselves. Not one person questioned the other.
What you see is what you are.
It's not my place to disagree.
Leave well enough alone.
And that is what they did. Each was left to their own imagination, to see themselves however they wished. It was an amazing thing how people imagined themselves to be. Out of shape, people said.
What a hunk, 100% muscle.
Not very good looking, people said.
You look beautiful.
Dirty, people said.
A bath in 3 days, but as clean as ever. What's the hot smell?
And then it happened. He came as a voice in the wilderness. With a loud voice, heard across the land of mirrors, he proclaimed,
my name is Shine, and I have been sent to clean you up.
The people protested.
We don't need cleaning.
Oh, yes, you do. Look at those mirrors.
I beg your pardon.
Shine smiled and shouted back.
It's not my pardon. You need to beg.
And then he rushed from mirror to mirror, as if racing against time, frantically cleaning each piece of glass with fast-forward speed.
Who do you think you are?
Well, who do you think you are?
One by one, the mirrors were cleaned. Then people looked. They saw themselves for the first time as they really were. They saw others too, and they had mixed reactions.
Whoa, you need some work. That's who I am? I'm not sure I like that.
When Shine was finished, he stood among them and said,
you may not like what you see, but that is who you are. Until you see who you really are, you will never become what you're meant to be. And until you see the truth beyond imagination, you will never be set free.
And then he was gone. It took time, but the people of the land of mirrors adjusted to their images and changed and grew. And seeing who they really were, they learned who they could really be. And in knowing the truth beyond imagination, they were set free. Their mirrors became windows to what is and to what can be.
As insignificant, not worthy to become before God, fearing the stains are too deep to clean from the sins you're guilty of. Don't feel as though you're not worthy to dine at his table of grace, nor even to gather the scraps that fall, nor look at his loving face. But see yourself clothed in garments fit only to clothe a king, eating as his honored guest and wearing his signet ring, for that is how God sees you, a worthy child indeed. Royal priesthood bearing his name the moment you came to believe. For surely as Christ's blood has washed you, you shall be whiter than snow. So don't see yourself as someone unworthy, a tiny speck nobody knows, for that only belittles the value of Jesus Christ's spilled blood. For it's thou blood, his blood shall cleanse you, and show that he's much loved. He says, my child, you are precious more than you can comprehend, for nothing you've done could lessen my love, for I'd always call you my friend. My heart just longs for you to come and bask in my embrace. My child, I will always love you and pour out my mercy and grace. So don't feel afraid to draw near, nor feel you have no worthy. My son's blood has purchased you. He has
Amen.